quickly dip into the latest news break that is coming in right now. In terms of the voting percentage, the third phase of election has concluded, and many would suggest if you look back on elections 2024, it would be the third phase which would prove to be the decisive phase. As of now, half of India has already voted. 50% of the Lok Sabha election, Lok Sabha seats have already cast their vote. Let's quickly dip into the voter turnout. At 5 p.m., the voter turnout reached 60% across 11 states and one union territory. Highest voter turnout recorded in the state of Assam. Lowest voter turnout recorded in Maharashtra at 53%, while Assam recorded a 74.86%. Gujarat also voted in a single phase today. Let's break it down. Karnataka stood at 66.05%, Madhya Pradesh 62.28%, Maharashtra 53.40%, Uttar Pradesh 55.13%, West Bengal 73.93%. I want to quickly cut across to my colleague Moshmi joining us from Madhya Pradesh. Important big fights, you know, this time around. Moshmi, voting percentage Madhya Pradesh was extremely low this time around is what is being reported. What are you picking up from MP? Big fights there that voted. You are in Guna. Jyotiraditya Sindhya, first time fighting on a BJP ticket. When he fought on a Congress, he'd lost. And also the neighboring constituency of Rajgarh, Digvijay fighting his last election from Congress.
Right, Preeti, you know, the Gwalior Chambal region, almost 9 seats in and around this area went to the polls. It's extremely hot. The temperatures are crossing 41 degrees Celsius. And, you know, there's about 62.28% voting in Madhya Pradesh. Last time round, Guna had reported almost 70% of voting. So there is a dip in voter percentage even in Madhya Pradesh, though it's not the lowest if you look at the array of lowest states that have shown a very low percentage. But three bigwigs were contesting and were in the fray, from Vidisha Shivraj Singh Chauhan, Jyotiraditya Sindhya, and of course Digvijay Singh. And, you know, perhaps the parties were hoping that the voter turnout would pick up from phase three, considering the fact that now on the phases are strongholds of the BJP, where the BJP in the last three, four phases did extremely well. It will be a very, very catch-22 situation as to what actually this low voter turnout really depicts. Does it impact the opposition, or does it, one generally believes, is a low voter turnout is actually disadvantageous to the ruling party? That's the question that everybody would want to find an answer to.
All right, appreciate you joining us, Moshmi, with the latest coming in from Madhya Pradesh. But let's get you the final voter turnout that has just come in. Overall voting percentage has just come in, 60.92%. I'm going to, you know, break it down for our viewers. Of course, you know, there will be an addition of a couple of percentages, but this is what the baseline figure is going to be, viewers. At overall voting percentage in the third phase stands at 60.92%. Assam at the highest, recording 75.01%. Assam remains the highest. The lowest is the state of Maharashtra, recording 53.95%. Bihar 56.50%. You have Goa 74%, Gujarat 56.12%, last time it was well above 65%. The state of Uttar Pradesh has folded at 57.03%. Maharashtra, like I said, the lowest, the highest coming in from the state of Assam. Very close to Assam is the state of West Bengal that has voted 73.93%.